Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, you're highly welcome. My name is Zara. I'm a medical student in the University of Nigeria, and I make videos about med school, study with me videos, and other related videos like that. If you've not seen my previous videos, don't worry, they're going to be linked in the description box and up here somewhere. So do well to check that out when you're done with this one. To beat around the bush, I'm just going to go straight into it. I'd like to start by saying that there are two kinds of uni in Nigeria. In fact, everywhere in the world, there's a high yield uni and there's a low yield uni. The high yield uni are those that over the years have built a name for themselves and are considered the top uni in the country, okay? And the low yield uni are unis that are probably just starting up or have not built that reputation or a name for themselves. If I were to advise anyone, honestly, I would tell you to go to high yield uni because they built a name for themselves. Obviously, they have a reputation to protect, they have a name to protect, they have a standard to uphold, okay? And sometimes, in all honesty, when it comes to like job opportunities, they hear certain universities, they would quickly give you. So why not just go to a high yield if you can? But to go to a high yield university, you have to make sure that you have high scores in JAMB, high scores in post GTME, and a very good WAEC result. Why am I doing this video right now? Because I know that a lot of unis have started selling their post GTME forms and candidates have started applying to these unis. So that's why I'm doing this video. So when it comes to choosing a right university to study medicine in, when it comes to any course, there are certain general criteria. But when it comes to medicine as a department, there are certain things that you should really consider, okay? First of all is the professionalism. I mean, the lecturers, your professors, your cons, whoever is going to be teaching you, they should be very, very professional. They should know what they are doing. I know that a lot of people want to believe that they know what they're doing in life, but you want to go to a uni that they know what they are doing. I mean, when they teach you things, try as much as possible to make your research. Honestly, I didn't go into medical school without knowing anything, okay? I knew things because I was lucky enough and I was privileged enough to have a cousin. My cousin was in medical school at that time. She's a doctor now, but she was in medical school at that time, and she gave me information that I needed, okay? And when I got into medical school, I met seniors that would give me information about the next class. So I never actually went into medicine without like knowing what's up, you get? So you want to make sure that, I mean, the professionalism of your uni is really strong. I mean, professors that probably studied outside the country, professors that did their masters outside the country, lecturers, whatever it is, but they know what they are doing, they know what they are teaching. Okay, hey guys, so sorry to interrupt your viewing. Editing Zara here. I left out something while I was filming the video. It's just a very normal mistake. Actually, before you check into the professionalism of the uni that you want to go into, you have to make sure that medicine and surgery is accredited in that university. Accreditation simply means that that result is recognized. There are certain criteria for accreditations that I really don't know. So you want to make sure that medicine and surgery is accredited in that uni. How are you going to know, you may ask? That's why you have to make your research. You have to ask questions. You have to ask people. You have to look for people that are doing that course in that uni and ask questions. That's just the easier way to do it. So you have to make sure that that school has been accredited, medicine and surgery has been accredited for the school, okay? Because accreditation, without accreditation, your certificate will not be recognized, or you won't be given certificate immediately you graduate. You have to wait for maybe a few years when your school now gets accredited before you're giving your certificate and before you can practice. And this is the fact, this is the most important thing that you have to consider when choosing your uni, if medicine and surgery is accredited in that uni. Then also you want to make sure that your uni has a teaching hospital. I don't know if any university in Nigeria that is offering medicine and surgery as a course doesn't have a teaching hospital. If you do, please comment down below, but I don't know if any doesn't have a teaching hospital. But just in case, you want to make sure that you need that you're going to go into have like a teaching hospital, because that is very important and vital to your clinical life, okay? Now, speaking of clinical life, you want to make sure that there is a good clinical foundation in whatever uni that you're applying into. I mean, good clinical foundation, because you don't know where you're going to find yourself, you know, honestly. You don't know if you're going to leave the country, maybe write USMLE and leave, write PLAB and leave, whatever it is your plan would be. You don't know where, like, life will take you to, okay? So you want to make sure that that school has a good clinical foundation. What do I mean by a good clinical foundation? Your clinical skills, like basic skills like history taking, examination, they know how to do it. I don't think any doctor, let me not exempt anybody, okay? But good clinical skills are really the thing in medicine. It's the basis of medicine. Medicine is not about the theory aspect. Yes, the theory is for the knowledge, to know what to do when the time comes. But the knowledge of clinical application is what medicine is about. You want to try and make sure that there are enough specialties in the uni that you want to choose, enough surgical specialties, enough medical specialties. I know that surgical specialties in some unis are still upcoming, and you want to make sure that they have at least the basic ones like general surgery, neurosurgery, cardiac surgery, cardiothoracic, plastic, urology, you know, pediatrics, basic surgery. I mean, depending on, you don't know what your interest would be, okay? So you want to make sure that you try and go around this unit, okay? Then in medicine, internal medicine, family medicine, O&G, this would shape how your future will be, honestly. So you want to make your research, because you're not just getting into uni to get into uni. You're getting into uni for a purpose, to come out as a successful doctor. And to be a successful doctor, if your clinical skills are trash, you have not succeeded. Be the best graduating student in your class. If your clinical skills is nothing to write home about, your patient care is nothing to write home about, you have failed woefully as a doctor, okay? So also your preclinical foundation should be strong enough, because your clinicals are placed on your preclinical foundation. Your preclinical, basically you do anatomy, physiology, biochemistry. So you want to make sure that at least there are practical aspects to these courses, because as I said, medicine is not only about the theory aspect. In as much as there's a theory and you can always imagine, but there is nothing like, you cannot compare your imagination to actually seeing the actual thing, okay? So example, in anatomy, cadavers, that you can practice on cadavers is actually a blessing, because it helps strengthen your anatomy knowledge of the human body, okay? So choosing a school that provides cadavers is a plus side, okay? Then also the practicals in physiology, practicals in biochemistry, you may not really understand them when you're doing the practicals, but they are going to help you, because you can go back to them in the future. I mean, it helps. So yeah, so for me, that is it about, okay, there's a minor one, but it's not really, it's like a general, make sure that your learning environment is conducive. I mean, a big classroom, you know, all of that. Like, a conducive learning environment will shape how you learn, but that is really minor compared to making sure they have a good preclinical foundation and clinical foundation, and also the professionalism. These are things that you should consider when choosing a uni to go into. I know that a lot of people would want to mention names of top universities and all of that, but no, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to mention names of top universities or any of that, because I only attend one uni, okay? So I really don't know the learning conditions in these unis. So I can't say, oh, this is the best uni to go to, this is not the best uni to go to. But do find your research. If you know anybody in the uni that you aspire to go into, find out. If you don't know anybody, if you happen to live around that area, go to the uni, look around, find a friend or something, and communicate with this person about, oh, I want to be a medical doctor, this, that. Make your research. Don't just sit down and wait for everything to come to you. Sometimes you have to go out and look for the information that you so desire. So that is the end of the video. I hope this video was helpful to someone one way or the other, and I hope that everyone who is preparing for post-GCME exams, I wish you good luck. I wish you success. For WAEC, people writing WAEC right now, the best of luck, you guys, because I know how it was in my time, and I wish you guys the absolute best. And I hope that all your desires, all your dreams, all your wishes come to reality, because that is the best feeling in the world. So I'll see you guys in my next one. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you have not. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, if it was helpful to you. If you want to help me, give this video a thumbs up and leave comments down below what you think that other criteria that I didn't mention here. What other criteria that you think that people should consider when choosing a uni to study medicine and surgery in? And I'll see you guys in my next one. I love you as always. Bye.